Hey, what's up guys? Phil here with Transfer Superstars. On today's video, we're gonna be doing an unboxing and review on an infrared thermometer. And if you're wondering what a thermometer has to do with transfers, it's because heat is really important in what we do. We use heat for our heat presses, we use heat for our gas dryer, and we also use heat to create our transfers. The perfect amount of heat creates the perfect cure. That's why you guys have perfect transfers. We got this from Amazon. It is a highly rated product, has almost 40,000 reviews. That's why we went with this product. Let's go ahead and unbox this so that we can take a deeper look into this. And the brand is E-Tech City. So let's take a look. One of the beauties about this product I noticed is that it actually comes with a battery already. So that's something that you don't have to get on the side. Let's go ahead and plug this guy in. It does come with a 9-volt. I do notice that the wiring here is a bit flimsy, but as long as it works, it is a good value. So let's go ahead and plug this one in. And it reads both in Celsius and Fahrenheit, so that's pretty nice. Let's go ahead and turn it on. All right, so it ranges between 58 degrees to 1,022 degrees Fahrenheit, so it covers a pretty wide range. What's also nice about this is that in case you don't turn it off, it actually turns off by itself, just like you just see right there. The backlight LCD display is also really nice so that you can use this in the dark. And one of the main reasons why we chose this model in particular is because it has dual lasers, as you can see right there. The dual laser is supposed to be more accurate. It's also quicker, but you do need to use this at 14 inches in distance. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what that looks like. I'm going to use this box as an example. I'm going to use a measuring tape. So that's about 14 inches right there. I'm going to go ahead and use the gun, turn it on. You just got to press the trigger to turn it on. But from a distance, you just point at it, and that's 14 inches right there. What you're looking at here is that both lasers actually meet in the middle. And that's how you get an accurate reading. So if I move this ahead, you're gonna see how the line splits. If I move it backwards, it's gonna do the same. So the magic number is 14 inches. Just like up top right here, if I go back up, when I hit 14 inches, that's where the midpoint is at. So that's how you have accurate readings with this. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna go ahead and test our heat presses, our dryer, our shaker, so that we can test the different temperatures. So you guys wanna watch to the end. You guys don't wanna miss out on this. I'm gonna go ahead and before we head out there is to test the table, just so that we know the temperature reading, it's gonna be semi-accurate. I'm getting a reading of about 72 degrees right now. So let's go ahead and see what this table reads. Let's go ahead and change that to Fahrenheit, scan again. So it's about 1 or 2 degrees off from a thermometer here. Let me see it again right here. Yeah, it's about 1 or 2 degrees off. This is also not a thermometer to use on human, but I'm gonna test my temperature anyways just to see what the readings are. So again, our body should read somewhere around 98 degrees. Not gonna really shoot myself, but I am gonna shoot myself. So I hope this is going to be dead center in the middle. Let's see how it reads. All right, so that's the temperature that we're getting. Again, I don't see it, but I think it's going to be a little bit off, couple temperature off, maybe 3 or 4 degrees. Again, it's not for the human body, because if you have a fever at 104 and it reads 100, that's not a good thing. But if you're talking about equipment, it's going to be more accurate. So let's go ahead and walk to our heat press machine so that we can test out the temperature. So the first thing we're going to test as far as temperature is the GeoKnight. This is a 16 by 20 clamshell heat press. So we're going to test how accurate the settings are with the infrared gun. So let's go ahead and turn this guy on. We're going to let it heat up to 300 degrees, and then we're going to test the underside to see if it actually hits that temperature. All right, so we got our GeoKnight set to 300. We've hit that temperature. Let's go ahead and see how accurate it actually is. So I'm going to go ahead and point my gun right in the middle. I'm going to make sure that both lasers are going to be centered so that it's going to be the 14 inches. And as you see, it's about 308, 309 degrees, which is higher than the 300 that I set. I'm going to go ahead and actually press a shirt to get rid of any of the heat that is currently on there. The heat press should actually regulate at about 300. It'll go up and down because it's constantly keeping that temperature. As long as it's not going too crazy, then it should be fine. So here I just pressed a shirt. Let's go ahead and measure temperature. About 308, 309. That's pretty much where it's at. 307. And I'm also checking for some cold spots, if there's anything. Everything seems pretty easy, even 300 up top right there. So it's back down to normal. It's about 304, 303. So it's pretty accurate, plus or minus 5 degrees. It's not gonna make or break a transfer right here. So this one works pretty well. Let's go ahead and check out the other machines. All right, guys, the next machine we're going to be testing out is the M&R gas dryer. This is a Sprint 3000. It's one of the top-of-line gas dryers. I'm going to go ahead and turn this on, and then I'm going to go ahead and start the pilot. What we're going to be achieving is to hit 280 degrees. It's currently at 114. What it does is it purges the line first, and it starts to roll the belt, and then it'll slowly increase to the temperature that we want it to hit. And then we're gonna use the gun and test to see if it actually hits that temperature. So we got the Sprint 3000 up to 280 degrees. Let's go ahead and check the inside to make sure that the temperature is accurate. Now, one thing to keep in mind, this is really important for us because we do water-based printing. It has to cure right, so temperature is very, very key here. So let's go ahead and test this out. As you see, I'm getting readings of like 275. This is pretty accurate. There are different blades out there. Again, it's a really long dryer, so I don't quite have my hand all the way in there, but it pretty much hits the temperature. It's gas regulated, but it's pretty accurate. The next item we're gonna be testing is this Stahls Hotronix Hat Press. This is one of the best hat presses in the market. What I really like about this is that it has a dual heating element. So you get the top and the bottom. So we're gonna go ahead and turn this on, wait for it to heat up, and then test that heat on both of these to see if it's gonna be accurate. Two heating elements. Let's go ahead and test the top, and let's go ahead and test the bottom. So I set both of them at 300 degrees. I'm gonna be at 14 inches distance. Gonna go ahead and fire. Both lasers are about the same. I'm getting 286, 87, degrees. So plus or minus is about 15 degrees. And let's go ahead and test the bottom part of this. So 14 inches. I'm getting about 250, 245. So it's definitely less than the 300. I'm not exactly sure how this heating element works. It actually might trigger when the hat is actually getting pressed because it's constantly heating up and trying to reach temperature. That actually might be an indicator for it to fire up. I'm not exactly sure. So far, this has been pretty accurate. Maybe it's something with this hat, but we've never had a problem with this so far. So let's go ahead and test one more item. Now we're gonna go ahead and test the temperature on our shaker. Again, this is for our DTF transfers. It's really important that not only is the temperature right, but you also have the time in the dryer correct, because too quick, you're still gonna have humidity in your prints. So you just need to dial it down correct. But let's start off with the temperature to make sure that we're on point. So I have this set at 145 Celsius, which is roughly about 295 Fahrenheit. Let's go ahead and see how accurate the shaker is. All right, so 290, 285, 270, 260. Again, it ranges, but it hits that temperature, as you guys can see right there. Now, this also goes up and down based on how much air this is getting drawn up. So the faster that this is drawing up air, the more the bulbs are heating up. And so that's why you see the fluctuation in temperature. But so far, it's pretty good. We just got a couple more things to test out. Let's go. And this is our fully automatic heat press. We got this from Asia. It's air pneumatic. We're gonna go ahead and test the element to make sure that it's even as well. Let's go ahead and turn this guy on. Now this is given in Celsius, so we're gonna let it go up to 150 Celsius, which is roughly about 300 degrees. And then we're gonna test underneath to make sure that it hits that temperature. All right, guys, this is the last one that we're doing. This is our air pneumatic heat press. This is one of the machines that we use on a daily basis. Again, it's really important that we have the temperature correct. I have it currently set at 150 Celsius, which is roughly about 300 Fahrenheit. So we're gonna go ahead and go underneath and we're gonna go ahead and test that temperature. So make sure that we're about 14 inches distance, and you see it's about 300, 299, 296, 280, 295, 301. So far, it's pretty accurate. I'm glad I was able to use this, test out all our machines. It gives us a clear indicator on where we're at. In cases like a flash machine or a shaker, it might be missing a bulb, it might be running cool. So there are various reasons why this is helpful. I'm gonna go ahead and drop a link below on this Amazon product. Let me know if you guys have any questions. I hope this video helps you guys out. Make sure you guys hit like, make sure you guys hit subscribe. I'll be dropping videos every week. I'll catch you guys on the next one.